GIS stands for Geographic Information Systems, and this is a career pathway in high demand.
The GIS pathway is a 3-semester commitment from students.
And this is the first time we open GIS courses for high school students to earn college credit. They start at the high school with an introductory level course taught by one of the teachers here.
And it's open to everybody, whether or not they want to commit to the whole pathway. And during that, they learn the very introductory skills of how to build map layers, what maps are used for, how to make their own app that uses spatial data. And that includes learning how to fly drones and incorporate those drone images into their GIS map layers.
Then they move on to take an online course through NMC, taught by one of our instructors.
So it's a college-level GIS class for college credits.
But they will have a tremendous amount of support because they have a local teacher facilitating sessions face-to-face, and then they'll have a mentor from NMC, a student mentor, that's going to accompany the whole sequence. Then they go into a third semester when they are placed in an internship with a local organization. That's where they get money to complete work that has been designated by that organization.
They've mapped nesting sites of Kirtland warblers for the Asabla Institute for Environmental Research. They've mapped the treatment of invasive species in the national park system over in the Sleeping Bear Dunes. They've mapped macroinvertebrates along the Boardman River where dams have been taken out. So it's fun scientific data gathering in the field that the students get to put into a visual map format, so that all of the story that is told by that data is more accessible to the general public. Then they prepare to take an entry-level professional certification exam. The student who has just gone through this pathway has received thousands of dollars worth of training for free, 6 college credits, and a professional certification with the exam fee covered. And they can step out of high school and be employed at a living wage in the field of GIS. Or they could step out of high school and decide, you know what, I have a pretty great resume. I'm gonna go apply for that college I didn't think I was going to be able to get into, because now I can say I've worked in my community. I have these GIS skills. I already have these college credits. And all of a sudden, they become a more viable candidate for that school they weren't sure if they could get into.
So there are many different applications of this kind of knowledge that people are already familiar with. We want students to understand that they can design their own apps.
And that is not all that difficult to do in reality.
But also to analyze information and ask really good questions.
So if I'm a high schooler who is really passionate about science or really passionate about the environment, or I have a passion that I know I want to make a change in the world in some field, I think about all of the people in the GIS field across different content areas who have taken their passion and magnified their impact through the use of maps. And that gets me excited.
We're offering a wide range of options for many different kinds of students. If they want to be better communicators, this is a good route. If they want to be better programmers and design apps, this is a good route. We are offering this for free and making this option available to any student. So I would encourage people to check it out.